Donkey of the Day.
Donkeys of the Day, ask Charlamagne.
I'm a Democrat, so being Donkey of the Day is a little bit of a mixed up.
So like a donkey.
Yeehaw.
Okay.
Donkey of the Day.
The Breakfast Club, bitches.
Now, I've been called a lot in my 23 years, but Donkey of the Day is a new one.
Yes, Donkey of the Day for Wednesday, May 31st, goes to Kathy Griffin. Now, if you haven't heard, Kathy Griffin has been getting some very negative COVID based off an image she posted yesterday. And the image was of herself holding up the bloody severed head of this country's celebrity in chief, Donald J. Trump. Now, Kathy Griffin is a comedian, which is what all comedians like to remind us when they forget to be funny. I'm staring at this picture. I have examined it. I have looked for captions she may have added to it to make it funny, but nope. I can't find it funny. I don't expect much from my comedians. I just want them to be funny and smart in that order. This pic of Kathy Griffin standing there holding a bloody severed head looking like a real housewife of ISIS is not funny. Not to mention, I keep telling you all, you can't threaten the president of the United States of America. Look, I know that it's hard for us to deal with the reality that the executive producer of the Celebrity Apprentice is the president of the United States of America, but he is. And you can't threaten the life or hint at violence when it comes to the president. Threatening the president of the United States is a Class E felony under United States Code Title 18, Section 871. It consists of knowingly and willfully mailing or otherwise making any threat to take the life of, to kidnap, or to inflict bodily harm upon the president of the United States. Why do some of you people choose to learn this the hard way? I will never know. And there's a bunch of you out there listening to me right now saying, what about all the threats made to President Barack Obama in the White House? Or even before the White House? President Obama's life used to get threatened all the time. Yes, it did. And people got arrested for it. Google is your friend, bro. Simply Google people arrested for threatening President Obama. It's a long list of people who have been arrested and indicted for a variety of threats against former President Barack Obama. So don't think for one second that just because you don't see the media doing a lot of COVID on people who have been arrested for threatening the president, that it's not happening, because it is. Now, the Secret Service didn't approve of Kathy Griffin's art, as she called it. They promptly tweeted out, on it! Mm-hmm. At Secret Service monitors open source reporting and social media to evaluate threats. Threats made against at Secret Service protectees received the highest priority of all our investigations. See, here's the thing. You don't have to force making a statement against Donald J. Trump. This is what Kathy Griffin did. She forced it with this severed head, okay? You don't have to do that against a man who gives us so much great material all the time. Last night, 12:05 a.m., our celebrity in chief tweeted out, despite the constant negative press COVID. I'm sure he meant to type coverage, but his thumbs must have had a stroke, and instead of coverage, he spelled out COVFEFE. Kathy Griffin, that's material. The funniest comedian on the planet right now is the internet. And the internet has been having a field day with COVID all morning. They didn't have to reach for bloody severed heads to find material. Now, Kathy Griffin apologized. Let's hear it.
Hey, everybody. It's me, Kathy Griffin. I sincerely apologize. I am just now seeing the reaction of these images. I'm a comic. I crossed the line. I moved the line. Then I crossed it. I went way too far. The image is too disturbing. I understand how it offends people. It wasn't funny. I get it. I've made a lot of mistakes in my career. I will continue. I ask your forgiveness, taking down the image, going to ask the photographer to take down the image, and I beg for your forgiveness. I went too far. I made a mistake, and I was wrong.
Fought on that apology, man. I hate apologies like that. And people always start off those apologies by saying they are sincere. Nothing sincere about that. Okay? You received a lot of negative press COVID. Secret Service jumped on your ass. CNN said they found your image disgusting and offensive. And you do the New Year's coverage with Anderson Cooper every year on New Year's on CNN. And CNN said they are evaluating that New Year's Eve gig. So now that the pressure is on and you think you may lose money and possible sponsorships, you fake apologizing. Kathy Griffin is a grown-ass 56-year-old woman. You mean to tell me she didn't realize that bloody severed head wasn't a good idea until she put the image out and got back? Backlash for it. That's when she realized she went too far. Nobody on her team, nobody around her said, Kathy, you know, this isn't a good idea. Not only could this be considered a felony for threatening the president, it's simply not funny. The man literally gives us material every other day. So a message for Kathy Griffin and any other comedian or artist who wants to make a statement against the celebrity in chief. Don't go chasing Donald Trump's severed heads. Just stick to the misspellings, pronunciations, and dumb covifi Donald Trump is bound to give you. Please give Kathy Griffin the sweet sounds of the Hamiltones, please.
You are the donkey of the day. You are the donkey.
By the way, Donald Trump tweeted about 40 minutes ago that Kathy Griffin should be ashamed of herself. My children, especially my 11-year-old son, Baron, are having a hard time with this. Sick. Yep, Kathy about to get audited. She getting held up at airport security. They're not going to respect her clear, her pre-check, her JetBlue, even more speed. Nothing.
When it comes, they're going to make an example out of her.
They might. They might. When it comes to the president, we have to stop making emotional decisions and start making strategic ones. Don't bring a bunch of negative covifi into your life for nothing.
The Breakfast Club.